Hi class, welcome to another lecture on CS575. This time we will be looking at the Box-Jenkins methodology for ARIMA models. So Box-Jenkins are basically the names of two statisticians. We will come across them. And I would like to thank Dr. Mohammad Alamed for the wonderful slides. I got it from his website. An excellent tutorial for the following lecture. So we begin now. Okay, so ARIMA model basically is autoregressive integrated moving average. So you must have studied the autoregressive models. You must have also studied moving average models. And integrated basically stands for how many times do you difference the model to make the models to make the time series stationary. All right, so we will look it into more details. They were popularized by George Box and Galvin Jenkins in the early 1970s, right? So almost 50 years old, but it is still very relevant for in today's time series prediction. So ARIMA models are a class of linear models. This is an important term. It's a linear model that is capable of representing stationary as well as non-stationary time series. Now, first of all, when we say the word linear model, that means it cannot be applied to data which is non-linear, right? So we cannot apply it to non-linear data. Second thing, it is capable of representing stationary as well as non-stationary. Now let us make a use of a pointer. So see all these AR, MA, right? So we have the AR model, we have the MA model, we also have the ARMA and ARMA and ARIMA. All this wants that the series should be stationary, right? With a constant mean and variance. But it says that it can be also applied to a non-stationary. So when you have a non-stationary time series, you first convert that station a non-stationary time series into a stationary time series. So as you know, there are various methods to convert those. First being the differencing, the easiest. So you subtract the current from the previous values of the time series and then try to see whether you are obtaining a stationary time series, right? ARIMA models do not involve independent variables in their construction. Now, what does this mean? So, for example, so let's say we have a model something like y is equal to mx plus c. So, in this case, we call y as a dependent variable and x as a set of independent variables. So, when you have a multivariate time series, that is number of, there are more number of columns in the time series. You can have a bigger model saying m1 x1 plus m2 x2 and so on. So all these x1 x2 x3 are assumed to be independent variables, and the term on the left hand side, this is known as independent variable. So what does it say? It says ARIMA models do not involve independent variables, right? So that means ARIMA models does not involve such kind of x1 x2 x3 and x4. They make use of the information in this series itself, right? So what happens now? So basically they say they make use of the information in the series itself, right? So they make use of the series existing. So for example, what we do is like current y of t is equal to, let's say, some constant plus some coefficient beta into y of t minus 1, right? So this is basically an AR model. So what do we say? That the current value of my time series will be equal to some constant into coefficient into the previous time series that I got. The whole logic here is that the current value has a dependence on the previous values that we have, which is very inherent in nature, right? So ARIMA models have these properties. They do not involve any independent variable like y equal to mx plus c. This is basically independent variable. So they don't involve such independent variables. They directly use the series itself, right? Then ARIMA models rely heavily on the autocorrelation, right? So as we know, autocorrelation is basically if you have a series, right? So let's say 1, 5, 7, 2. So autocorrelation means, so usually a correlation basically what happens, or a covariance, it says if you have, let's say, x and y, so when x changes, what is the change in y? That is how we what we get in covariance. But in case of autocorrelation, it means we take a x and we take the lagged version of x. So what will be the lagged version of x is? So for example, x, so x of minus 1 will be, so I keep 5 as here, I keep 7 as here, and I keep 2 as here, right? So basically then I compute the multiplication and then divide by the total number of points I have, and then basically compute the variance and basically calculate autocorrelation, right? So a series with its lagged version. So this is lag 1. What will be lag 2? Now I keep 7 as here. Then 2 I will keep it here. So as you see, as you move along the right hand side, for example, in the lag of 3, you will have only the value of 2, right? So you can see from this, as we move along the right hand side, this value will go on decaying, right? Because in the first case, I will have a multiplication of 1 into 5 plus 5 into 7 plus 7 into 2 and 2 into 0, because this is a lagged version. In the last series, it will be just 1 into 2, right? So as we move along the right hand side, along the time, it is also obvious, because a very lagged version of a time series will really have a very less dependence on the last point from which we are computing. Now, Arima methodology of forecasting is different from most methods because it does not assume any particular pattern, right? So for example, Arima model does not assume the presence of any particular pattern in the historical data. So it uses an interactive approach. As you can see in Arima, there are three models basically. We have the AR model, we have the MA model, and I basically stands for differencing. So we will see more details about this. Then, so we build the model iteratively, and then we choose a particular model that gives us a reduced error. So in the last class, when we did the practical on Arima, so you remember we gave PDQ, we tried for different values, and then based on the lowest value, we choose a particular model. So we were building the model iteratively. So this is just a basic time series. So time series is basically a sequence of data. Now you already know this, so I am skipping. So for example, whenever you see a time series data, you need to answer two questions. First, does the data exhibit a visible pattern? So what can be the pattern? The pattern basically can be whether the data has a trend, right? Whether it has a seasonality, right? Or whether it is completely random. Right, so does it have a pattern, and can this be used to make some meaningful forecast? So the data may have a pattern or may not have a pattern. Whether can we use this particular information that can help us forecasting? So we need to find out. So for example, like we have studied simple exponential smoothing or double or triple exponential smoothing. So what happens here? If you have a trend in the data, you need a double exponential smoothing. If you have a seasonality, you need a triple exponential smoothing. If you have a kind of a constant data, you need a simple exponential smoothing. So that is the meaning, can we make forecast? So what is the Box-Jenkins methodology? Again, kept on the name of these two scientists, refers to a set of procedures for identifying, fitting, and checking Arima models. So we are doing three things here, right? So can you see this? This is basically task one, right? This is task two, and this is task three. So the basis of Box-Jenkins approach to modeling time series consists of three phases. First is identification, second is estimation, and third is the application. Application is nothing but basically forecasting, right? First is the identification. So you identify, as we know that this is a linear model, so we need to check whether the series is stationary or not stationary. If it is stationary, you can apply the models. If it is non-stationary, we need to first convert it into a stationary time series based on the techniques that we have studied, and then estimating and testing, right? So as we will see, Arima models basically involve three parameters, P, D, and Q. P basically, these are the parameters. So based on the various values that we obtain from graphs like correlation, partial autocorrelation, and differencing, we basically estimate and test for different values and try to fit a model. So I think I will stop here for this lecture. I try to keep my lectures short. So this was just a basic introduction. So Box-Jenkins methodology is a set of procedures for identifying, fitting, and checking Arima models, right, for time series data. So these are the major three steps. So that's it for this video class. Thank you.